helping leaders motivate their people to a higher level of performance through strong human relations, team building, and goal achieving. This is the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast with your host, Paul Falavolito.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast, episode 170, and let's talk about navigating conflict. As an EMS chief, one of the key challenges I face is managing conflict within my team. In high-pressure situations, differences in opinion and misunderstandings can happen, potentially impacting the team's effectiveness and overall mission. So for this episode, I want to outline the diplomatic approach I use to handle conflicts within my team. And if you listen to the last episode, I said communication is always on every list. Well, here we go again. Establishing a culture of open communication is crucial in preventing conflicts from escalating. You have to encourage team members to express their opinions, concerns, and ideas freely so you can create an environment where everyone feels valued and heard. Regularly scheduled team meetings, briefings, debriefings, and informal check-ins also provide platforms for individuals to voice their thoughts, facilitating a proactive approach to conflict resolution. And when conflicts arise, it is essential to practice active listening. You have to allow team members to express their perspectives fully and ensure their voices are heard. Active listening involves you giving undivided attention, you seeking clarification, and you summarizing the points being made. This helps individuals feel validated and promotes a deeper understanding of their concerns, also facilitating the resolution process. The biggest point I can make is the understanding that conflict resolution should be a collaborative effort within the individuals having the conflict, rather than a top-down approach. When conflicts emerge, you should encourage team members to work together to find mutually beneficial solutions. By involving everyone affected, you not only empower individuals to take ownership of the problem, but also foster a sense of shared responsibility and unity within the team. And in more complex conflicts, it may be necessary for you to act as a mediator or facilitator. As an EMS chief, sometimes I play a vital role in guiding discussions, ensuring a fair process, and providing support to help the team reach a resolution. When you remain impartial and objective, you can help to bridge those gaps, facilitate compromises, and build consensus among the conflicting parties. And also another important concept is that feedback is a powerful tool for growth and conflict prevention. When you can encourage team members to provide constructive feedback to each other, emphasizing the importance of maintaining a respectful and a solution-oriented approach, team members can address concerns early on, minimizing the potential for conflicts to escalate. You can also document agreements made between both parties and be sure to follow up with them just to make sure everything is still good. And the last point is offering training in conflict resolution techniques so you can equip your team with valuable skills for navigating conflicts effectively. Consider organizing workshops or inviting experts to provide training on conflict management, communication, and negotiation. Providing your team with these resources will not only enhance their professional development, but also strengthen their ability to handle conflicts constructively. Conflict is inevitable with any team, especially in high-pressure environments. People are going to argue and verbally fight with each other. Welcome to what happens when people are passionate about a project and cannot agree on a path forward. My approach may not be the approach that suits you. I know many leaders that prefer a direct and candid approach and speak openly and freely. Whichever approach you choose, always remember that a positive outcome is what's best for your team and your organization. This has been the 7-Minute Leadership Podcast, and I thank you for listening.
For more Paul Falavolito podcasts, visit paulfalavolito.com.